generous.
Thank you.
I don't even know. There's a battleground called Blood Ring, huh? Check that out when we're actually not playing hardcore. Can't type.
can kiss your ass goodbye.
First kill. Normally on that quest, it takes forever to get the voodoo charm. So, I don't know if I was just lucky or if they've tuned the quest to make it easier. Probably the latter.
Kiss your ass goodbye.
Hey, what's up, Pembo? Yeah, man. I love Turtle WoW. Yeah, I like Turtle WoW a lot. So, I'm done with Everlook. There was too many shenanigans and just drama. And then, I'm not going to say I'm completely done with retail because I do want to see some of the new zones in Dragonfly, but I just felt like, I feel like Turtle WoW has been pretty much the most fun I've had on a private server in a long time, so I wanted to come back to it and explore more of the game. Oh no, Misty, no way, is it? I just moved, Misty, and I have a different internet connection. It's not as good. So, that makes me really sad to hear you say that. Yeah, I know. The internet's not as good here. There, I'm pulling it up. Although I streamed earlier today and everybody said it looked okay. So, here, I'm pulling it up on my phone right now. Looks fine on my phone. When you say it doesn't look as good, I mean, how does it not look as good? Yeah, but I really hate to hear you say that. Really? Well, that doesn't make sense. You should be able to read the level. Are you? But I can clearly read the level on my screen here. Are you on a phone or are you on a computer? Like a. That sucks. I hope that. I mean, you're on your computer? Huh. I mean, it really shouldn't be any different. I mean, the settings are the same. Yeah, I mean, it really. I mean, I was. I don't know. I'll ask some more people. Hopefully, it's just something on your end. Because, I mean, I had other people watching the stream today and they said that it looked fine. So I'm hoping it's, you know, just something on your end. I don't see it like. A second. I do have an internet tech guy coming out tomorrow to look at my connection because it's not as fast as it should be. But unfortunately, where I moved from a place where I had fiber optic to a place that doesn't offer fiber optic. So unfortunately, my internet's not. I mean, it's like I went from 200 meg up, 200 meg down to theoretically what this should be is 1,000 meg down and 30 meg up. So the up speed's not as good. It's 30 instead of 200. The downspeed, obviously, I don't even care about the downspeed. The upspeed is actually more important. So yeah, I'm kind of ticked off about that, but there's nothing I can do. Unfortunately. I'm testing it right now. Speeds look okay. I mean, speeds look okay right now. Should definitely be plenty. You know, 30 gig up should be plenty to stream. Yeah, man, that makes me so mad. Hey, Josh, what's up? Torn Shaman, cool. Does anybody else see any difference in my stream? I mean, is there anybody else watching that feels like the quality doesn't look as good? I mean, like, when I look at it on my phone, I think it looks pretty much like it normally does. Let me pull it up again. Yeah. Looks pretty good on my phone. I'm able to read the level on my phone when I'm looking at my stream on my phone. It doesn't look any different than it normally does. Okay. Can you read, hey Josh, can you read my character's level here? Level 11. Can you see that clearly? Okay, well, I think, I'm hoping, Misty, that it's just on your end. Because so far everybody else has said it's been pretty much looked okay. I know my ping isn't as good, and I haven't been able to get, like, for whatever reason, they did something to Turtle Wow because, like, my exit lag is not picking up Turtle Wow like it used to. It used to pick it up, and now it's not picking it up. I don't know why. Einbei, what's up? Hey, Einbei. Do you see any difference in the quality of the stream, Einbei? Because I am running with an internet connection that just... I just don't have the same up speed I had before, and there's nothing I can do about it. I've only got 30 or 35 meg up, where before I had 200. So, tell me if the stream looks okay. And good morning, by the way. Okay. Whew. All right, that's good. Because Misty said it didn't, the quality didn't look as good. But so far, everybody else I've asked said it looks pretty much, okay. But that's good. I mean, it really shouldn't because I'm, according to OBS, my connection is excellent. And I don't see any issues with the stream. According to OBS, it looks fine. I do have an internet technician coming tomorrow because unfortunately, like I said, I don't have fiber optic anymore. I have cable, which sucks. But I have a guy coming tomorrow because my speeds are not as fast as they should be. I'm should be getting a gig down, and I'm not. I'm only getting like 300 to 500. So he's coming tomorrow, and I'm actually gonna, if I even if I have to bribe the guy, I'm gonna say, "Hey man, what can you do to get my uploads to be better?" I'm like, "I'll give you cash on hand right now." I'm literally gonna bribe the dude and say, "Whatever you could do. Tweak the line. I don't care what you have to do. Say a freaking voodoo prayer." It doesn't say up to 1 gig for the download. It just says 1 gig. And on the person I talked to on the phone said I should be getting much faster speeds than I'm getting, and that's why they're sending the internet tech out. But this is cable, and the way cable works usually, because I've dealt with internet for years. I've had so many different connections. The way cable usually works is based on it's on a big, it's on a big bandwidth, and since I'm in an apartment complex where everybody's using the same cable. I mean, we're all using the same provider. Typically, that pipe can only handle so much. Oh shit. Okay, this is not good. I can get this guy down. Okay, I did. Whew.
You can kiss your ass goodbye.
You
can kiss your ass goodbye.
That's always the, one of the hardest pulls in this particular area is that one right there. Yeah, so typically with cable, they say 1 gig, but because of the bandwidth restrictions, usually. It can vary based on the time of day, you know what I mean? Yeah. I could tell you when they first set it up though, Ein Bay, I was getting like 700 meg down and it's slowly degraded and I'm, you know what I mean, like if I check you right now, we're getting, see, we should be getting 1,000 meg down and look, we're only getting like 330. I should be getting 1,000, but honestly, I don't care. Like at my last place, my last place, my internet connection down was only 200. It's not the download speed I care about; it's the upload speed. Now I'm getting 27, but that's actually about what I'm supposed to get because I'm supposed to get 30 up, but I'm actually getting more. So I'm actually getting more upload speed than they said I was going to get, But because they say I'm supposed to get 1,000 down, and of course, for streaming purposes, just streaming to multiple devices in my house. The text's gonna come out, and like I said, I'm gonna do everything I said. Can you increase the upload speed at any? I don't care what you do. I said, is there any way you can increase it? Because I stream and I need as much upload as you can give me, you know? Yeah, but as long as you guys, as long as it looks like the stream is okay, does it looks pretty good, then I'm happy, Like I said, my internet connection, I got my ping here is like the ping on this server I'm getting right now is like 130, whereas on my other connection it was like, you know, 110. So that sucks. My ping's not as good, at least not to this server. And for whatever reason, exit lag isn't picking up this client. And I thought exit lag picked up Turtle WoW. Pretty sure it normally does. But I did large Kronos earlier today, and exit lag did pick up Kronos. So I'm not sure why it's not picking this up anymore. No idea. But I do like my office a lot better, Aimbe. Like if you look at the, like, so here's my new office. I like the way it's laid out better. Like I have the desk coming out like a V shape out of the wall here, and you know, I don't have carpet. I have like kind of these fake hardwood floors, but, and what's really cool is I have this ceiling fan that's dim it, you know, I can dim the light, and it also has like a soft light mode, so it goes from like a kind of a white colored light, like almost like, you know, to a kind of orangish yellow light or something. So it's actually really cool. Yeah, the office, like, and I've got the ceiling fan right above me, and the ceilings in this complex are a little bit shorter, a little bit lower because it's an older complex, but which I thought I wouldn't really like, but I actually really like it because the ceiling fan's closer to me. Like in my apartment, my last place, the ceilings were really high, so you couldn't really, like, if you turned on the ceiling fan, you really couldn't feel a whole lot. But here, man, it's like there's a freaking, my own personal cyclone that swirls around me. I'm on the third floor, man. Yeah, I've got a dimmer switch on the light. It also changes colors between like a kind of a fluorescent light color to like this orangish thing. Yeah, so that's pretty cool. Am I in the right spot? I'm in the wrong spot, aren't I? Yep, I think I am. One thing with Turtle WoW on the Paladin is you get Redoubt, like right off the bat. So right off the bat, we're putting points into Redoubt. So, which is awesome. and it procs off of not just crit strikes against me, but any strike against me has a chance to proc for doubt. So protection paladins in Turtle Wild should be way, way stronger than protection paladins in regular vanilla. So that's what I'm excited about with this character. In WoW retail. Oh, really? You've seen a lot of prop valleys, huh? So how did you like the Iron Bay? How did you like the new talents? And the one thing I'd say about the talents, I find them a little restrictive. Like, I find the talent trees to be a little bit restrictive in that you have to go... I don't know, they're a little bit more restrictive than, say, like, Rift, you know, where you can end up getting most of the talents in a talent tree. If you wanted to pick, like, a certain soul in Rift, you could pretty much get most of the skills in that tree if you wanted to. I hope I'm going the right way. I think I am. I'm really tired, guys, because I've been moving yesterday and today, so I'm exhausted, actually, so I'm just trying not to die here. I don't want to die. I don't want to die. Yeah, whip moving sucks. Tomorrow, Wednesday. Did you see Lazy Peon's video, Ein Bay, on it? He did one recently on... It's been just over... On Dragonflight. He said he liked it, but he said he wasn't sure if it was good enough yet to bring him back to the game full-time. I seriously doubt that, but... I thought it was interesting, he said, yeah, I didn't like Lazy in the beginning because I found him to be really unskilled, like he just wasn't very good at playing MMOs, but I feel like what he's good at now is he has a pretty good understanding of what makes an MMO fun, so that's why I do watch his videos sometimes, but he's kind of, you know. But yeah, initially he was just this, I mean, he's just a kid compared to me. He's just a kid, but... I thought it was interesting that he said he felt like the quests were more fun than he remembered, like the questing and was more fun, but he said he felt like it was mostly because of the dragon mount flying, you know what I mean?
You can kiss your ass goodbye.
Was this one hand? Sure. Alright. Percent chance. Boom, redoubt. Level 12. Oof, slow and steady. Hardcore. Exhaustion. Level 12. Oh, one thing he did do, Ainbei, was he said he found a website where he could go. I guess there's these achievements or these certain things you have to do to increase your dragon flying, and he found a website where he basically ran around the world and basically leveled up his dragon flying to max before he even, you know, finished leveling his character to max, so that at that point he had max, you know, dragon mount flying, I guess, whatever benefits that give you, I don't really know because I don't play Dragonflight that much, but so I'm sure that made doing the quest easier because he probably could fly faster, or who knows, could fly longer, I don't really know. I'm not sure what all the dragon flying systems like, really, as far as like skilling it up. Yeah, that's it. Glyphs, I think, in the world to unlock more energy or something. I mean, really, my stream really should be fine because, like, I did some tests and I can tell that when I stream, it's using about 8 meg, or it's using about 8 meg of my upload speed for the stream, about 8 meg. So I still have about 30, you know, or about 25 to 27 left over. So if it's only using 8 for the up and I still have 25, 27 meg left over, then really the stream should be fine. We have plenty of bandwidth. The nice thing is World of Warcraft is, you know, not exactly the most intensive video game to stream. You're just gonna do 160 to first and feel the new talents? Gotcha. But you can see how much stronger the Paladin is here in Turtle because I've got Crusader Strike and Holy Strike. Whereas in normal vanilla, I wouldn't have those abilities, so all I would have is Judgment and Auto Attack pretty much. That's why Paladin never felt like it was a finished class in original vanilla. It just felt like, man, you just don't have any abilities, you know. It felt off. Makes you really wonder why they didn't implement. Because from what I understand, Holy Strike and Crusader Strike are actually there in the kernel. I say kernel. But, you know, I mean, they're there in the code. They just weren't implemented. But they were there. Like, they were in the code. Like, those skills existed inside the 1.12 clients. Just for whatever reason, they weren't enabled for Paladin. Makes you wonder. And it makes me wonder. Hey, can you? Hello. Did you see Cargos's musical videos, Einbay? Hey, Einbay, did you see Cargos's songs that he created? They were actually not, they weren't bad. There were a couple cringy moments where he sounded like Justin Timberlake singing, which was very cringe. He wants me to kill a gall, but other than that, they weren't too bad. And I don't know if I told you, Wall messaged me about his... Yeah, that's true. That's true, yeah. It's funny, like, the more we learn about, you know, Vanilla WoW, the more we learn about World of Warcraft in its initial state, I mean, we realized that the game wasn't really finished. I mean, they released a product that wasn't really a finished product. I mean, they weren't... You know, they would like to have had more time. Let's just put it that way. Dude, what is it with YouTubers who feel like they have to be singers, you know what I mean? What is that? I mean, I it could just be the personality. Like, I play guitar. I like to sing. Maybe this is that personality. Like, people who like to stream, like to be... You know what it is? It makes perfect sense, though, Ainbe. Because musicians are people... Like, if you... Excuse me. If you, like, do interviews with, like... If you hear interviews with famous musicians, they always say that there's basically something wrong with us. Because we feel the need that we have to be in front of an audience to be vindicated, like to stroke our ego, so to speak. I mean, a lot of them say, you know, hey, there's obviously something wrong with us, because if we don't feel right unless we're in front of thousands of people screaming our lungs out, you know. But you like to, they're performers. You like to perform. But if you go to Cargo's channel, check. He reminds me so much like Justin Timberlake, and I hate Justin Timberlake. But I like Cargos. I actually think Cargos is a cool guy. Although he did do a post again on Alex Central's YouTube video one time, and I was like, dude, how can you give this guy any credit? He's such a douchebag. Snowflakes are falling in Dunbarrow, Torrens and Mogor all dressed like gnomes. From Barons to Elwyn to Silver Pine, there's... I thought part of it was pretty cringe. Especially this, listen to this right here. Just one thing on our mind. You know, obviously he's doing this, my yine, and just, you know, like I said, Justin Timberlake. But I do like the chorus. I thought you did a really good job with the chorus, Josh, on this one. Listen to the chorus. With every zone, with every quest, I hope you'll make it with no death. So that chorus was pretty good. I'll give him the chorus on that one. I thought the chorus was good. But it's from a good place. He's coming from a good place. That's the thing, you know, Cargos loves vanilla. The reason I like Cargos is because, you know, obviously he loves Vanilla WoW. That's just like me, man. I love the game. It's all about the game. It's for the love of the game. Yeah, but the core, he did a great job with that chorus, though. In every zone, in every, you know, what was it? Every zone, every breath. I hope you make it. Like Christmas without bread. Yeah, but it was pretty good. I mean, some of them were, the first time I heard it, I kind of like went, ugh, you know, like kind of cringed, because I was like, you know what I mean? I went, oh, that, he hit a couple notes singing, and I was like, oh, that was bad. But the whole point was, it's all in good fun, and also, you know, they're on December 15th, everybody's going to get together and start leveling up hardcore characters again. You know what I mean? And so I guess we'll see. You know, I don't really understand this, what they're talking about, this fresh thing they're doing. I'm not quite sure what it is. But if you go to that video, there's a pinned comment. And I think it's on here. So right here, in addition to give some... here it is. Everyone, by scheduling a classic era fresh day. So I think what they're saying... Basically, what I think what they're saying is that everybody's going to start leveling hardcore characters at level 1 on Thursday, December 15th. And then, in addition to give some incentive to spread the hardcore spirit, we invite everyone, Alliance, Horde, high-level, low-level veterans of the race, to join us January 1st as they try to take down the world boss, Azure Ghost, on Bloodsail Buccaneers. So I think that's pretty cool too. So I'll try to jump in and get in on those two events, I think. Just because it'll be fun, you know. I'm level 12. I may want to go back to Stormwind and hit the trainer. I can't remember what skills I learned at level 12. think it's just Seal of Righteousness, maybe. Who knows, though? It's Turtle Wild, maybe different. I don't think I can. I'm not sure if I can take out the elite guys. Oh, he's not elite. Oh, he is elite. He's only level 9. I'm a little concerned about trying to take out this guy. All right, man. Yeah, with a tech guy. I'm a little concerned that I might not be able to kill this Oaken Skull at my level. I was talking to Dale earlier, and he said he does hit really hard.
You can kiss your ass goodbye.
And the dog comes back today. My wife's parents have been watching the dog since Friday night. So that's been a godsend. You know, moving without worrying and worry about the dog has been huge. Yeah, I'm gonna wait. I don't wanna risk it. It's too early in this leveling character to start risking. Besides, we can go get this other quest done, and I think it rewards a nice ring for us. This one here. So it's going to give us a ring. It's going to give us 3 stamina, so that's going to be very nice. they just keep chasing me. Yeah, those casters are a pain in the butt.
You can kiss your ass goodbye. Thank you.
They keep spawning Pathfinders, but that's not what I need. What I need are Avengers. They keep spawning Pathfinders. Pull this one. Shit, first I gotta kill Horse of the Mauler as well. Crap, I got some shitty gear. I tell you what, let's turn these quests into Darnassus, then let's go back to Elwynn Forest and knock out these lower level quests. Because it'll give us like, some gear, low level gear. Let's do this quest. There's just so many quests. So many quests. Thank you. Level 12. So many quests to do in Turtle WoW. And we're gonna do them all.
Thank you. Thank you.
I think it's probably time to go back to maybe Stormwind area and knock out some of those quests. We can basically knock out all these quests here in Elwynn Forest, and then we'll come back and pick up Darkshore again. Plus, I also need to get the Paladin training. Shit, I forgot we could flag ourselves PvP. Crap, that was stupid. Alright, well, let's get into Stormwind, then I'm gonna log out. I'm gonna go to bed anyway, I'm tired. But yeah, we gotta be careful when you're in hardcore, because you can't... You know, I just buffed somebody who was flagged PvP, and now I'm flagged PvP. That can be a dangerous thing to do. Alright guys, I'm gonna go to bed. That was a little, I actually got flagged PvP there, which is kind of stupid. You gotta be more careful about that when you're buffing people. But I'll probably stream tomorrow morning, so I'm just gonna go to bed now, because I'm pretty tired. It's 1:30 in the morning. But what I might do is come up and start streaming tomorrow morning around 7 a.m. So, 7 or 8 a.m. for maybe, an hour and a half. And then I gotta go to work. I hope you guys have a good night. Thanks for stopping by, and hopefully we'll... Actually, we did pretty good. She was only level, we're slow and steady, so we're only getting 0.5 XP. So, to go through an entire level, and a little bit more than that in just an hour and 40 minutes, is actually pretty good. I'll catch you guys later, man. Have a good night, everybody. Peace out.